Dear students, in this video, I explain you Unit 3 prose, that is The Collectors. The Collectors is a one-act play about the encounter of a group of teachers and children on an adventure walk in a lonely countryside with two aliens. The aliens have taken the form of humans and hence the group takes shelter in their spaceship, mistaking it for a house. Those two aliens tried to abduct that group of students and teachers. Before starting the play, know the glossary. Porch means covered entrance or portico. Weird, strange or unusual. Next, cheeky. Cheeky means disrespectful. Next, snoop means poke around. That is search. Next, stranded, trapped. Anorak, waterproof jacket. Potty. Potty means foolish or silly. Let us do some warm-up activity. Here two pictures are given in your reader. First, look at the first one. Okay, can you identify what are these called? Do you know who uses them? Okay. Of course, you might have seen them in the movies. These are called spaceships. Okay. They are used to move from one place to another place. Now look at the second picture. Is this a picture of a human? If no, what makes you think so? How does this alien differ from humans? Who are aliens? We can say aliens are some creatures or foreigners who are from other planet, not from Earth. And aliens can change their form from aliens to humans and humans to aliens. Right, if you observe, their eyes and ears are different from human beings. Okay. Now read the play to find out how aliens try to abduct. Abduct means trying to kidnap some humans and what happened to them. Who are the cast here? Pete, Carol, Tracy, Glenn, Vane, Dawn. These are the students. Mr. Hunt, Miss Swan, Mrs. Jones. These three are the teachers. Mrs. Brown and Mr. Brown are the hosts who give shelter to the students and teachers. Okay. Try to watch carefully. Okay. Till the end of the play, you carry some suspense. Now let us start scene 1. It is lonely countryside. The children are out for an adventure walk with teachers. It is raining hard. Miss Van says, "Isn't there somewhere we can shelter?" Mr. Hunt, "Not until we get to the village." So, as it is raining hard, Miss Van asks Mr. Hunter, "Isn't there somewhere they can shelter?" Then Mr. Hunt says, "Not until they get to the village." Then Mrs. Jones, "How far is that?" Mr. Hunt, "Nearly 3 miles." Dawn, 3 miles. Tracy, "I'm soaked." Okay. Miss Swan, "The children are getting very wet." Mr. Hunt, "I can't help that. We will just have to press on." Pete, "Can't we shelter over there, sir?" Mr. Hunt, "Where?" Pete, "There, in that house." Mr. Hunt, "That's not a house, surely. Hard to see in all the rain." Miss Van, "Of course it is. Try wiping your glasses." Mr. Hunt, "You are right. Lonely place to choose for a house. It certainly wasn't there when I was here walking last summer." Okay, so Pete finds some house there and he asks his teacher, Mr. Hunt, to go and
take shelter over there. Then Mr. Hunt said that he is hardly to see that house in all that rain. Then Miss Swan says, of course it is raining, try wiping your glasses. Then Mr. Hunt says, yes, there is a lonely place to choose for a house. And when he came to that place in the last summer, it was not there. Then Mrs. Jones, funny looking place. Miss Swan, are we just going to stand here in the downpour gaping at it? Don, yes, can't we go up there and ask for shelter, sir? Mr. Hunt, we can't take all you crowd into a private house. You are dripping wet. The remaining teachers and the students are requesting Mr. Hunt to go and shelter there. But Mr. Hunt says that he cannot take all the crowd into a private house as they are dripping wet. All their clothes were wet. Mrs. Jones, there is probably a shed or garage. We could shelter there. Miss Swan, we can at least ask. Vene, yes sir, why not? Tracy, I'm freezing. Mr. Hunt, oh, all right. So finally Mr. Hunt agrees to go there and ask for shelter. Next, scene 2, inside the kitchen of the house. Mrs. Brown is standing with all the children and teachers. Mr. Brown comes in through the outer door. What is the scene 2? Inside the kitchen of the house. Okay. Mrs. Brown is standing with all the children and teachers. Mr. Brown comes in through the outer door. Then Mr. Brown says, I have hung up all the wet clothing in the porch. Porch means covered entrance or portico. Okay. He had hung up all their wet clothes in the porch. Mr. Hunt, I don't know why I am still holding this walking stick. Mr. Brown, give it to me. I will put it outside with the other things. Mr. Hunt, it's all right. I will hang it on the back of this chair. Okay. So Mr. Hunt hang his walking stick on the back of that chair. Mrs. Brown, now that we have all introduced ourselves, why don't you children sit down? Mr. Brown, and the grown-ups can come through into the sitting room. Mrs. Brown, you children will be all right here, won't you? There is not room enough there for everyone. Okay. Then Mr. Brown asks the teachers to come and sit in the sitting room. And Mrs. Brown says that the children will be all right there in the kitchen. Okay. Because there is not room enough for everyone. Then Carol says, yes, thanks. Glenn, oh, yes. Pete, we will be fine. Mrs. Jones, thank you very much for taking us in like this. Mr. Brown, our pleasure. Mrs. Brown, there is a fresh pot of tea made in the other room. Would you like a cup? Miss Swan, I would love one. Mrs. Jones, so would I. Mrs. Brown, would you like to come through then? Okay. Then Mrs. Brown asks the teachers to come to the sitting room. Okay. Mr. and Mrs. Brown and the three teachers go out. The children are silent for a moment or two, looking round. Okay. So Mr. and Mrs. Brown and the three teachers go out. Where they went? To the sitting room. And the children are silent for a moment or two in the kitchen. Okay. They are looking around. Vane, you can't hear any sound of that wind in here. Tracy, no, it's terribly quiet. Word means strange, unusual. It looks, that kitchen looks unusual. Don, I can just hear their voices in the sitting room. Glenn, it's cold in here too. Vane, maybe we feel cold because we are tired from all that walking. Tracy, and we did get wet. Glenn, no, not just that. It is cold. Pete, and empty. This kitchen reminds me of a hospital. Where do they wash up? Then Pete expresses his doubt that kitchen is empty. Okay. And it reminds him of a hospital. Okay. And where do they wash up? Then Don says, in the sink. Tracy, or the washing up machine. Pete, there is nothing like that. Carol, there is nothing standing about either. No plates, no pots and pans. Things like that. Then Carol finds nothing in the kitchen. No plates, no pots and pans. Okay. Dan, they will put away in cupboards. Then Don says, they will put away in cupboards. Then Vane opens a cupboard near the back door. Vane, this one is quite empty. Then Vane opens a cupboard, na? Then he finds nothing. Don, don't go poking about, Vane. Then Don warns Vane, don't go poking about. Poking means look around, okay? Don't search for anything. Then Pete opens the fridge door. Did he find something? Let us see. Pete, there is nothing at all in this fridge and the light's not on. It's not even working. Okay. So Pete, when he opens the fridge door, he finds nothing and even the lights are also not on and it is not even working. Tracy, leave things alone, you two. It's cheeky to snoop. Besides, they might come in and catch you. Then Tracy also warns. Okay, what? Leave things alone, you two. It's cheeky. Cheeky means disrespectful. Okay, to snoop means poke around, search around. Okay, they might come in and catch you. Carol, I thought there was something a bit strange about Mr. and Mrs. Brown. Then Carol also says he thought that there was something a bit strange about Mr. and Mrs. Brown. Pete, funny you should say that. So did I. Glenn, perhaps they are crooks. Means they are criminals. Who says? Glenn says that they are criminals. This is their hideout. Tracy, they had hardly have let us in if they were crooks, would they? Don, no, that's silly. Okay. Carol, maybe we ought to have gone on walking to the village. Then Carol says, maybe they ought to have gone on walking to the village. Don, we would have got drenched then. Mrs. Brown comes back into the room. Mrs. Brown, all right here, good. Then she notices the partly open cupboard door. Okay. Oh, were you looking for something in that cupboard? Don, it was Vane. He was being nosy. Mrs. Brown, I see. She closes the door then, looking at Vane. Vane says, I didn't mean any harm. We just wondered where you put your plates and things. Then Mrs. Brown says, I would rather you didn't touch anything. We have just moved in and haven't had time to sort things out. That's why this place looks rather deserted. So what the reason Mrs. Brown gave? Okay, that the kitchen is empty. They had moved in recently and haven't had time to sort the things out. That's why that place looks deserted. Means empty. Pete, we only wondered. Mrs. Brown, yes, well, would you all like a drink? Tracy, I would. Glenn, me too. Mrs. Brown, will orange juice be all right? Vane, yes, please. Don also says, fine, thanks. The others also nod. Okay. Mrs. Brown, good. And remember, please leave these cupboards alone. Okay. While she is leaving, she told them to leave those cupboards alone. Vane, we will. Pete, don't worry, Mrs. Brown. Mrs. Brown, She looks at the closed doors of a larger cupboard on the opposite wall. One more cupboard is there in the kitchen, okay, on the opposite wall. Okay, while she is leaving, she looked at that closed doors of that larger cupboard. Do remember that. I will go and get those drinks. She said, do remember that. Okay, what? Not to open any cupboards. And she will go and get those drinks for the students. She goes out. Carol, did you see her hand? Don, no, what? Carol, when she closed that cupboard door, I looked. She has 7 fingers on both hands. Tracy, who? Horrid. Pete, I was watching her eyes. Glenn, yes, as far as I could see, they were all one. They were all one color. They didn't have any black sort of centers. Vane, gone. She could be something weird like a vampire. Tracy, oh, shut up. Okay. So they observed her eyes are different. No black sort of centers in her eyes. Then Tracy also says, oh, shut up. As Vane says, they may be vampires. Don, yes, shut up. You are making all this up to scare us. Pete, no, we are not. Tracy, I don't want to stay here. Vanne, I will tell you something. The train has changed to thick fog outside. I have been watching it. Glenn, yes, you can't see anything out of that window. Carol, no, I hope it doesn't mean we are going to have to stay here all night. Tracy, stay here all night, not me. Okay, so here Tracy is scared. Okay, Don, I don't fancy that either. Let's go. Don also wants to leave that place. Glenn, we can't just slide off. Pete, I will go and tell Mr. Hunt and the others how we feel. So then Pete says his other friends that he will go and inform this about the kitchen and Mrs. Brown, okay, to his teacher Mr. Hunt and other teachers also how they feel there. He goes out. Vanne, it is all a bit mysterious. I wonder what's in that other cupboard. Then Vanne says, it's all a bit mysterious, no? Strange, no? That's why he wonders what's there in that other larger cupboard. Then Don says, leave it alone, Tracy. If she catches you, she will be mad. Vanne, she won't catch me. So Vanne wants to open the other cupboard also and he wants to see what are there in that. He opens the cupboard door. Behind it are dials, digital readouts, colored lights and a mass of other electronic equipment. What he found in the other larger cupboard? Behind it all are dials, digital readouts, colored lights and a mass of other electronic equipment. Then Glenn says, what on earth is all that doing there? Vanne, is it some kind of computer? Carol, those things, are they figures or words? Glenn, some kind of foreign language. Tracy, look at all those lights. Don says, it's real space is stuff. What is all that? It is real space is stuff. Glenn, what could it be for? Vanne, spying. Okay, for doing the things secretly. Glenn, you think so? Carol, close the door, someone is coming. Okay, then Carol wants Glenn to close the door as someone is coming. They close the door, but it doesn't quite shut. It was not completely shut. Pete comes back in. Who came back? Pete comes back. Okay, Pete, I think we need help. Carol, what did Mr. Hunt say? Pete, nothing. He couldn't. Vanne, couldn't? Pete, I went quietly. I was a bit scared. The door of the other room was partly open. I saw Mr. Hunt first sitting there, not moving, staring at nothing. So what did he observe, Pete? When he went to the sitting room to say how do they feel in the kitchen to the teacher, Mr. Hunt, he went quietly there and he was a bit scared. Why? The door of the other room was partly open and he saw Mr. Hunt first sitting there. Okay, what was Mr. Hunt doing? Not moving, staring at nothing. Okay. Glenn, you mean he was thinking about something? He was tired. Pete, no, I do not. He was drugged. Miss Van and Mrs. Jones are the same. I crept a bit closer. Then I could see them too. They were sitting there blank, as if they had been turned to stone. And what else Pete told his friends? Okay, Mr. Hunt was drugged. And Miss Van and Mrs. Jones are also in the same position. Okay, he crept a bit closer. Then he could see them too. They were sitting there blank. Okay, they are doing nothing. Okay, they are simply looking blank as if they had been turned to stone. As they are turned to stone. Carol, and Mr. and Mrs. Brown? Then Carol asks, what about Mr. and Mrs. Brown? Pete, they were looking at them and I don't know, talking. Okay, then what Mr. and Mrs. Brown are doing? Okay, they are simply talking or not? Let us see. Carol, what were they saying? Pete, no idea. They were not really talking. It sounded they were just sort of hissing and clicking at each other. Tracy, I want to get out of here. when I'm getting out right now. Okay, as Petty said, all this Tracy and Vene are scared. They wanted to leave that place. He goes to the back door and tries to open it. Vene goes to the back door and tries to open it. It is locked. There is no key at all. Don, let me try. No, it just won't open. Glenn, how about the window? Okay, then Vene tries to open the window. Vene, no chance. It won't move. Tracy, smash the glass. We have got to get out. Then Tracy says, okay, Tracy says, smash the glass. Okay, they have to got to get out. Carol says, here, try Mr. Hunt's walking stick. Use that, Vene. Okay, then Mr. Hunt hang his walking stick there, na? Okay, then Carol says, use that walking stick. Vene tries to break the glass with the walking stick. Vene, it won't break. He hits the glass again. It just bounces off like a ball. Glenn, let me try. He takes the walking stick and uses it. It's no use. The glass is like steel. Pete, come on, we will see if there is a way out through the front. They begin to crowd towards the kitchen door when Mrs. Brown comes in with a tray of drinks. Okay, then meanwhile, Mrs. Brown comes with a tray of drinks. Okay, as they are trying to escape from that kitchen door. Then Mrs. Brown says, good heavens, what's all this rope? What on earth have you children been doing? Carol, we want to leave. Mrs. Brown, in this fog, how can you? Pete, what have you done to Mr. Hunt and the others? Mrs. Brown, done? Nothing. We have been having a cup of tea. Then Mrs. Brown says, okay, they did nothing to their teachers. They have been having a cup of tea. Carol, Pete says, you have drugged them? Mrs. Brown, nonsense. Where in the world did you get that idea? She notices the cupboard left partly open. Then she notices that larger cupboard left partly open. I do wish you would have the courtesy not to interfere with these cupboards. Glenn, what is that stuff in there? Mrs. Brown, what do you mean stuff? It is electronic equipment. It belongs to my husband. He is a scientist. It's part of his work. Then when Glenn asks about the stuff in the larger cupboard, Mrs. Brown says that it is the electronic equipment and it belongs to her husband as he is a scientist and it's all his part of work. Pete, and why is the back door locked? Mrs. Brown, it always locks when you close it. It is a burglar-proof lock. The windows are burglar-proof too. My husband doesn't want to run the risk of having any expensive equipment stolen. Okay, Tracy, they have been trying to scare us, saying there was something strange about this house and about you. Then Mrs. Brown says, how dare you, after we have taken you in and looked after you, after I have gone through the trouble of getting these drinks for you, the least you can do is to sit quietly and drink them. Pete, I bet they are drugged, just like the tea you gave Mr. Hunt and the others. Mrs. Brown, no, just stop that kind of talk. Pete, I saw them. You have got them in the other room. Drugged. Okay. Then Peter argues with Mrs. Brown that he had seen them, that they have got them in the other room. Drugged. Mrs. Brown, you saw nothing of the sort. They are all chatting to Mr. Brown right now. Then Carol says, ask them to come in here then so we can see them. Mrs. Brown, certainly not. I am not dragging them in here just because of a lot of children's silly fantasies. Then Mrs. Brown, disagrees to drag them into this kitchen. Glenn, well, let us go in there and see them. Then Glenn says, let us go there only and see their teachers. Mrs. Brown, no, you don't. I'm not going to be ordered about by children. Then Mrs. Brown disagrees for that also. She bars the way through the door. Carol, she can't stop us on her own if we all try to go. Then Carol wants to leave that place. Then he asks his friends, let us all of us try to go. Mrs. Brown, All right. I will go and fetch one of your teachers. Stupid children. Then Mrs. Brown wants to fetch one of their teachers. Then she goes out. Dawn, see, she is going to bring them. Tracy, they are not drugged at all. You were trying to scare us. Dawn, you are stupid, Pete. Tracy, it's an ordinary house and they are ordinary people. Still, Tracy and Dawn are not believing Pete. Then Dawn says, frightening us like that, you are rotten. Pete, I know what I saw. Give us that walking stick, Glenn. Glenn, here you are. Then Pete took the walking stick. As Glenn gives Pete the stick, both Mr. and Mrs. Brown come in. Carol, where is Mr. Hand? Mr. Brown, he won't be coming and you had better drink. Pete, don't anybody touch that stuff. Pete asks his friends not to touch that stuff. What is that? Drink, okay? Mr. Brown, it will make no difference. You can't escape anyway. Then Mr. Brown says that they cannot escape from there. Vinny, oh no, come on, Glenn, let's get past them. Glenn, right, okay? He and Vinny make a rush for the door. One armed Mrs. Brown brushes them away. They are sent flying across the kitchen. Then what happened? Mrs. Brown brushes them away and they are sent flying across the kitchen. Mr. Brown, stop that. We don't want any of you damaged. And either one of us alone is more than a match for any five feeble earth children. What Mr. Brown says? Okay, any one of them alone is more than a match for any five feeble earth children. They are equal to, their strength is equal to five feeble earth children. Carol, if you try to keep us here, the police will come looking for us. Mr. Brown, will they? They won't find you. You are going away. Tracy, no, where are you taking us? Mrs. Brown, shall I tell them? Mr. Brown, why not? It might calm them to know there is no avoiding their fate. Mrs. Brown, we are taking you to our home planet. Glenn, home planet? Carol, you are not from Earth, you are aliens? Mr. Brown, exactly. Then Mr. Brown reveals the secret. What? That they are the aliens and those want to take those children and teachers to their planet. Vane, but you are human, you look human. Mrs. Brown, we can take on any shape we wish for a time. So can our spaceship also. So they can take on any shape, aliens or humans, and they can change the shape of their spaceship also. Mr. Brown, at the moment, as you have seen, it looks like an earth house, very useful for our mission. Mrs. Brown, in a few minutes, we shall convert it to a spaceship again and return to our normal shape. Mr. Brown, so you had better drink. It will make the shock of takeoff easier for you. Tracy, but you mustn't take us. You cannot. Mr. Brown, how wrong you are. Vinay, but why us? Why pick on us? Then Vinay asks, why do you want to collect us? Mrs. Brown, you were available. We collect creatures from other worlds like you. Carol, why? What for? Mr. Brown, for experiment and scientific study, you will be useful to us. Pete, oh no, we won't. Okay, so for what they want to abduct, means kidnap those students and the teachers? Okay, for experiment and scientific study. Okay, and those will be useful to the aliens. Then see what happens. Flinging the cupboard door open, Pete holds up the walking stick, two-handed. Okay, come one step nearer and I smash this equipment. So he warns Mr. and Mrs. Brown, if they come up nearer to them, he will smash the equipment with the stick, okay, whatever there, the equipment in the cupboard. Mr. Brown, no. Mrs. Brown, do nothing yet, too dangerous. Pete, grab a chair, Glenn, and come over here. If they so much as move, smash all this. Glenn, right. Then Pete says, to take a chair. Okay, then Glenn is also ready with a chair. He joins Peter with the chair raised and ready. Okay, he raised the chair to smash all that equipment. Okay, Mr. Brown, smash any parts of those panels and you can kill us all. Petty, I will take that chance. Carol, you and the rest get near that outer door. Carol, yes, come on, you lot, quick. All the children except Petty and Glenn cluster against the door to the outside. Mr. Brown, they are only children. We can rush them, attack. Then Mr. Brown says, Mrs. Brown, okay, that they are only children, that they can rush them, okay, and attack. Mrs. Brown, no, they are wild. Keep still. Mr. Brown, we can't let this happen. Beaten by inferior creatures. Mrs. Brown, we must. If they break any part of that equipment, we are stranded here on earth. We can do no repairs here. Petey, you go and bring Mr. Hunt and the others out here. Mr. Brown, no. Then Peter taps the panel with the stick and swings it back for a real blow. Okay, that means he wants to smash the equipment. Then Mrs. Brown says, go, go and fetch them. Mr. Brown goes out. Peter, you, how do we open the back door and the door in the porch? Mrs. Brown, yes, all right. It's that control down there on the left. It's marked with yellow light. Press it. Glenn, don't trust her, Peter. Petey, I won't. Listen, if those doors don't open at once, Glenn and I start wrecking. Okay, wrecking means they will start smashing the equipment in the cupboard if the door doesn't open. Mrs. Brown, I'm telling the truth. Press the control. Press it. Petey, watch her, Glenn. And if this is a trick, use that chair. Glenn, don't you worry, mate. Petey presses the control and the doors open. Okay, on pressing the control button, the doors open. Carol, it's all right, Petey, it worked. Mr. Hunt, Miss Swan and Mrs. Jones staggered dazedly into the room. Mr. Brown is behind them. So meanwhile, Mr. Hunt, Miss Swan and Mrs. Jones staggered dazedly, okay, into the room. They are moving slowly as they were drugged. Mr. Brown is behind those teachers. Petey, help them. Get them outside and well away from the house. Vene, what about you? Petey, don't worry. Get going. The children help the adults out through the back door, leaving Petey and Glenn facing Mr. and Mrs. Brown. So all the other students and the three teachers were out through the back door, okay, leaving Petey and Glenn. So here only Petey and Glenn are left to face Mr. and Mrs. Brown. Now let us see how they faced Mr. and Mrs. Brown. Glenn, what now, Petey? They will grab us as we run for it. Petey, no, they won't. I have got a plan. You go first. Glenn, not without you. Mrs. Brown, we underestimated these creatures. They were never so fierce before. Mrs. Brown says that they underestimated the human beings. Then Mr. Brown says they were all drugged before, but not now. Petey, go through that other door behind you and close it. Then Petey says, go through that outer door behind you and close it. Mr. Brown, and if we refuse, Petey, you will be very sorry. He taps the panel again with the stick, okay, to spoil the equipment. Mrs. Brown, do as he says quickly. We have no choice. Then Mrs. Brown tells Mr. Brown to go and close that door. Petey, run for it, Glenn. Now, Glenn, right. Okay, then Petey and Glenn runs away. Glenn and Pete dash for the back door and disappear through it. Then scene, final scene, Moorland, a little later to that village. The whole party is sitting on the grass. It is neither raining nor foggy. Now the sun is out. Mrs. Jones, I can't believe any of it. Carol, but you remember being drugged, miss, don't you? Don and all our enochs were left in that house spaceship thing. Okay, then Don says all their enochs were left there. What are enochs? Waterproof jackets. glen and the house is not there anymore. Pete just vanished in a soundless flash. Miss Van, I know, but it's mad. It's incredible. Mr. Hand, we have to report it. Then the teacher, Mr. Hand, wants to report it. Okay. Then Miss Van says, don't be silly. How can we? It will sound utter nonsense. Mr. Hand, people disappear. Maybe they were collected as we were. Surely we have got to tell the story, believable or not, as a warning. So here Mr. Hand wants to report that as a warning. Then when he says, it will sound crazy. Tracy, I don't want people thinking I am potty. Tracy also doesn't agree for that to report. Okay, as people think he is potty. Potty means foolish or silly. Then Mrs. Jones says, I agree, say nothing. Okay, then Mrs. Jones also says, not to say anything. Mr. Hunt, I don't know. Swear everybody to secrecy. Anyway, I'm cold. Let's get on down to the village. Talk it over as we go. Here, the party moves off arguing. So, they moved on. Okay. Dear students, hope you enjoyed the play.